Depopulation was a crucial step in the agenda, as the Sustainable Development Goals had to be achieved. Green Marxism had successfully led the planet into panic that we would die from the lack of resources. They drove the story that global warming was to blame for some parts of the world to be unlivable conditions. They said they need to cut back the population, a thinning, needing to reduce countries' populations by 5% every year. Extreme brutal measures were introduced, all in the name of saving the planet. Aimed mainly at the elderly, they targeted areas so the sleeping masses wouldn't believe the scandal. Pandemics became more normal. It became a continuous pattern to blaming people for the evil they created behind the scenes, resulting in divisions and infighting amongst us. They moved people into the cities and emptied rural areas, villages and small towns. Buildings became abandoned and left to ruin. Apparently this was to allow the greener areas to recultivate with wildlife and animals. But the main aim was actually to centralise the people and get us all in one place. The cities became marshalled by police and military checkpoints set up. People were dragged along the narrative of the first pandemic until it was too late. They pushed disarmament priorities around the world, but it was only a way for smaller countries to surrender to the super states. A peaceful war, if you like. This disarmed the individual, taking away more individual rights, and still the military, police and security units had their weaponry. They knew they were creating a bloodbath. They had no remorse. Compressing our freedoms, crushing us, psychologically breaking us down through fear, depression, anxiety, resulted in mass deaths on a daily basis. Without your ID card, you could not maneuver in society. Even getting food was difficult. My heart bled as this horror swallowed us, and we blindly walked into the jaws of hell. How did it come to this? This involved everybody, but the resistance was still weak. The majority felt powerless and trapped in the fear spell, almost waiting for someone to raise us out of this with heroic victory. The reality was, there was no one coming to save us. We had to do this together. Health and data became the way life was analysed, all controlled by algorithms. The system decided the trajectory of every single life, only judged by their inverted values. All freedoms removed, even thoughts began to be erased. As if in a simulation, we were carried through their experiment with relative ease. The people that controlled it all were hugely successful behind their smokescreen, and we were under the illusion that they were just normal people like us. The fact was that they didn't even live the life we led. They saw it from their computers. They ate up the AI systems that fed them data. They decided the direction of the planet, but only because humans refused to trust their own guidance and denied their true connection. We let others steer our spiritual evolution and trapped ourselves within the false self. We had been carried on their ship for far too long and left to sink out at sea. Even some of the leaders who thought they would make it through were rejected. They only wanted people in their new world who would be controlled or dominated into submission. The AI system could only work this way. They know that humans can do unpredictable things, so they built the system to enforce laws with every possible outcome strengthening their power. However, there is a light. It is small, but we still have it. Their plan is still only in process. Intelligent people who think for themselves are dangerous to the central AI. Do you think for yourself? Do you trust yourself even when your views may be different from the masses? Ask the bigger question. How can you move through this world with integrity in every moment?